Good morning. All are welcome here as we gather for worship. Today we celebrate Christ the King Sunday, marking the end of the church year. Worship today is a journey through the liturgical year, the way the church marks time. Beginning with Advent and continuing through Pentecost, we will honor Christ the King, celebrating that the reign of God is love for us in all seasons and all times. Many thanks today to our confirmation students who've helped with the preparation for this worship service. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. God of grace, you have given us minds to know you, hearts to love you, and voices to sing your praise. Fill us with your Spirit, that we may celebrate your glory and worship you in spirit and truth. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Happy New Year. The season of Advent, the 4 weeks before Christmas, is the beginning of the church year. The color of Advent is blue, that clear, crisp blue that blankets the night sky just before the dawn. It's a color that symbolizes expectant hope. Not just Mary, but the whole creation is pregnant with possibility. During the season of Advent, we look not only toward our celebration of Christ's birth, but also toward that day when Christ will come again to fulfill God's reign of peace and justice, light and life. O come, Emmanuel.
But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they shall live secure. For now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one in peace, of peace.
Thine own from sin. rejoice, Emmanuel, shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou day spring from disperse the gloomy clouds of night, and as dark shadows put to flight, rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel, shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou key of David, come and open wide our heavenly home. Make safe the way that leads on high, and close a path to me. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel, shall come to thee, O
The season of Christmas begins with the celebration of the birth of Jesus and continues for 12 days, ending on January 6th. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in the baby Jesus. God extends care and compassion for all the earth in a new way. Heaven comes to earth. God's word, God's love, takes on flesh and bone. A baby is born, bringing light and life to all, symbolized by the white and gold that announces the Christmas season. His name is Emmanuel, God with us.
A reading from Luke. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those who he favors."
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching o'er silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed the Savior's birth. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in a lowly manger, the humble Christ was born. And God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
We celebrate the coming of the wise men to worship the newborn Jesus on January 6th. The day of Epiphany. White and gold symbolize the light of Jesus and remind us of the star that led the wise men to the infant king. Poet Jan Richardson invites us to imagine ourselves on that journey to worship Jesus. She writes, "If you could see the journey whole, you might never undertake it, might never dare the first step that propels you from the place you have known toward the place you know not. Call it one of the mercies of the road that we see it only by stages as it opens before us, as it comes into our keeping, step by single step. The road will take you to the place where at last you will kneel to offer the gift most needed, the gift that only you can give before turning to go home by another way." The season of Epiphany lasts until Ash Wednesday. The color of the season is green as we focus on the growing mission of Jesus. May you receive this reading from Paul's letter to the Corinthians, a reading from the season of Epiphany, as a word of blessing for you this day.
A reading from 1 Corinthians. To the church of God that is in Corinth, to those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be saints, together with all those who in every place call on the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, both their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech and knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him you were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Lent, beginning with Ash Wednesday, marks the 40 days before Easter. The 40 days of repentance, reflection, and renewal we experience during Lent mirror other biblical accounts of 40. The 40 years the Israelites spent wandering in the wilderness and the 40 days of temptation Jesus endured after his baptism. During Lent's 40 days, we are invited to carry out the Lenten discipline, practices of fasting, prayer, and works of love. We pray that God would help us to turn from sin and turn toward God. The color of Lent, symbolizing repentance, is purple. For a time of confession today, we use Psalm 51. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. According to your abundant mercy, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you, you alone, have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and blameless when you pass judgment. Indeed, I was born guilty, a sinner when my mother conceived me. You desire truth in the inward being. Therefore, teach me wisdom in my secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have crushed rejoice. Hide your face from my sins and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and sustain in me a willing spirit. Hear this word of forgiveness. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you. And for his sake, God forgives you all your sins. You are God's beloved. Amen.
What wondrous love is this, oh my soul, oh my soul. What wondrous love is this, oh my soul? What wondrous love is this that caused the Lord of bliss to bear the dreadful curse for my soul, for my soul? To bear the dreadful curse for my soul. When I was sinking down, sinking down, sinking down. When I was sinking down, I was sinking down beneath God's righteous frown. Christ laid aside his crown for my soul, for my soul. Christ laid aside his crown for my soul. God and to the Lamb, I will sing. To God and to the Lamb, who is the great I Am. While millions join the theme, I will sing, I will sing. While millions join the theme, I will sing. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing on, I'll sing on. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing on. From death I'm free, I'll sing his love for me. And through eternity, I'll sing on. and through eternity I'll sing on.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
At this time in the service when we would be receiving the offering, I thank you yet again for your continued generosity, the way in which you steward the tremendous gifts God has given to you. Thank you. Together we do God's work in the world. Let us pray. Merciful God, receive the sacrifice of our praise and thanksgiving and the offering of our lives, that following in the way of the cross, we may know the joy of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. The greeting rings out on Easter Sunday as we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. Easter is the high point of the Christian year, with the celebration lasting for an amazing 50 days. One day isn't enough. We rejoice at God's triumph over death for a time longer than our somber period of Lent. The colors of Easter, symbolizing joy and the light of the resurrection, are white and gold. Resurrection compels us to go and tell, in word and in deed, that death will never have the final word, that goodness is stronger than evil, that love wins even after our hearts have been broken. Resurrection calls us to live lives that look for resurrection, that practice resurrection, that dare to trust God. Poet Wendell Berry puts it this way in his manifesto that calls us to practice resurrection. Every day, do something that won't compute. Love the Lord. Love the world. Love someone who doesn't deserve it. Ask the questions that have no answers. Plant sequoias. Expect the end of the world. Laugh. Laughter is immeasurable. Be joyful, though you have considered all the facts. Practice resurrection.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples. He has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him.
Christ the Lord is risen today. Hallelujah. Raise your voice and triumph high. Hallelujah. Sing ye heavens and earth replies. Souls to save. Hallelujah. Where thy victory, O grave.
Pentecost is the 50th day of Easter, a day when we celebrate the gift of the Holy Spirit and the birth of the church. It's a grand culmination of a joyous celebration. The color of Pentecost Day, symbolizing the fire of the Holy Spirit, is red. The Holy Spirit, given on that day so long ago, continues to ignite hearts and inspire lives. In baptism, we are sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever. We are freed from fear to live lives of loving service, empowered by the Spirit. Martin Luther wrote that the Holy Spirit calls, gathers, enlightens, and makes holy the whole Christian church on earth and keeps it with Jesus Christ. We are in good hands. The season of Pentecost continues through the rest of the church year. It's named Ordinary Time because there are no major events in the life of the church that are celebrated. Ordinary makes the season sound dull, perhaps, or boring, but there is beauty in the ordinary. It's the time in which we spend most of our days. And this year, especially, wouldn't we give anything for ordinary days? The gift of the long green season of Pentecost, green symbolizing growth in faith, is that it invites us to see God in the midst of our daily lives, in the midst of ordinary routine, in the midst of the mundane. God is there. God is here.
When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place, and suddenly from the heaven there came a sound like a rush of violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them the ability. They came everyone, because many wonders and signs were being done by the apostles. All who believed there were together and had all things in common. They would sell their possessions and goods and distribute the proceeds to all as they had needed. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the goodwill of all people. And day by day, the Lord added their number, those who were being saved.
Thank you.
The church year ends with our celebration of Christ the King in all seasons and in all times. As God's people, we rejoice in the gift of love and the promise of life given by God for us. We leave our worship service today knowing that next week we enter in joyful expectation to begin a new year. As we leave this worship service, receive this blessing. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high will break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Almighty God, in whose hands the whole world is held, in whose hands you are held, bless you and keep you today and forever. Amen.
Go in peace, share the good news. Thanks be to God.